It is 8:15. You're tuned in to Talk AM 1320 WKAN.
And so happy to have joining us this morning Riverside President and CEO Phil Kambick. Phil, it's great to have you here.
Yeah, thank you very much, Allison.
Always enjoy having you on the show. So many things happening with Riverside right now. Wanting to talk about the hospitalist programs. Tell us a little bit about, well, first of all, what is a hospitalist?
Sure. Everything in healthcare is changing, and a hospitalist is a physician that only sees patients in the hospital setting. So a little bit different. They don't have an outpatient clinic. You don't go to see them in their office. They're only in the hospital, and they will consult with your primary care physician. They'll consult with other specialists, but they take care of you when you are in the hospital as an admission.
But Riverside's used hospitalists for years, correct?
And we've had this program for 12, 13 years or so right now for the adult population. And we're just rolling it out now for the pediatric population as well.
This kind of provides a more efficient way, I suppose, to care for patients.
It really helps in this case, our pediatricians. What happens, our pediatricians see patients in their office, and if there's an emergency at the hospital, they have to close their office and run to the hospital. Now we have pediatric hospitalists that will only be at the hospital 24/7, 365. If a patient comes into the ED and needs a pediatrician, these are the folks who will go see them. They will see the patients in the inpatient setting. If there's a high-risk delivery, they'll go to the OB area and help the OB physicians with the delivery as well. Mm-hmm. So they're always around the hospital, which is really much more efficient for them, and then much more efficient for our pediatricians to stay in their clinic and see patients in the clinic setting.
It does. Now that you explain it like that, it makes total sense. I can put myself in a position of, I couldn't really put myself in a position of being a doctor, but if I was, I would rather operate like that than have the stress of bouncing between places.
Oh, and think about it. If it's hard to get into a pediatrician as well, your child is sick, you're waiting in their office, and all of a sudden they come out and say, hey, I have to run to the hospital for an emergency. You can either wait for an hour, hour and a half, or we'll reschedule. You're not going to be happy as a patient.
No.
And the physicians don't want to do that to you, but that's kind of the model we had. This is a huge improvement over that model.
And it just improves care.
Right, absolutely.
And I would imagine and I know you're always looking at these things where patients and families are, you want them to leave satisfied.
Right, absolutely. Absolutely. And one of the nice things about this program is we're partnering with the University of Chicago Comer Children's Hospital. One of the best children's hospitals in the country, definitely in the Midwest here. And so there will be University of Chicago trained pediatricians on site Riverside 24/7. So phenomenal care that we're going to be able to offer within the hospital setting to really help all the families who come into Riverside.
I know you did the press conference and you kind of rolled this news out a few days ago, and Riverside is always doing something new and something cutting edge. The community response for this seemed to be incredible. I mean, I was just hearing so many people were excited, people who had kids, people who don't have kids. Mm-hmm. It's just one of these things that the community has really responded well to.
They absolutely have. And from my perspective, it's just bringing great quality care here. You know, I've had family members, as you guys have. I was born and raised in this community, live in this community, and we've had to go up to Chicago for the specialty care. It's a hardship on families, just driving through the traffic, trying to figure out where to go in this huge hospital of UFC or Northwestern or Rush, and it's stressful. Now, a lot more of those patients can stay in the community and go to Riverside, where they don't have to commute, they don't have to drive, they can go back and forth between their home and still see their loved one.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great point. It's already a horrible time in your life if you're dealing with needing to take a child for care for this. You already have so much stress, and then you add the stress of the travel as well.
And being away from family, being away from everything else, you work and everything that ties you to this community.
Yeah. So this is a huge change.
Yeah, we're very excited about it.
It is... It's the kind of thing where you have to be thinking that this is really going to change the landscape of healthcare locally. That's part of the mindset, isn't it?
No, absolutely. We always at Riverside looked at how do we improve? How do we help the community? That's why we're here, right? Mm-hmm. To provide care for the community. What are those next best things that we can do here? So we're always looking at how can we innovate? How can we add new programs? How can we help people stay in the community for their care? Versus going up to Chicago or one of the academics. Now, with that being said, mm-hmm. the academics in the children's hospitals, they are great. Mm-hmm. They do some phenomenal work, right? But if we can bring some of those providers here versus going to them, it just makes it easier for everybody.
Pretty amazing developments, and we feel really fortunate to have an organization like Riverside here in our community and with the continued commitment to the Kankakee area.
Yeah, absolutely. Wonderful. Thank you, Bill.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it, and keep up the great work. We have a quick break to take, and we'll come back with more of the WKAN Morning Show with Bill and Allison after this.